Police divers were out at a pond in Hartford today searching for key evidence in at least two homicides.
News 8's Jamie Murrell got a chance to see them in action. He has the story for us.
Police also follow the rules, but in this case, as you look at the sign, they are justifiably given a pass.
Our detectives are certain that there is evidence in this pond, as well as the West Hartford Police Department's Detective Division also.
Somewhere in the murky, shallow depths of Hartford's Pope Park Pond, police believe there is a murder weapon, or murder weapons, that if found could break a case wide open. But this is no easy swim.
Yeah, the visibility is certainly less than 6 inches, especially once you start to stir things up. They went in there with cameras earlier, and the cameras did not work so well.
This is actually West Hartford's dive team. They are here because of new information surrounding a January 2010 case where Christian Torres was killed on Park Road. But they also could find the weapon used in a Capital City murder in 2009 that took the life of Matthew Rivera on Dover Street.
We have some pretty good information that a murder weapon is in the pond here, whether it's for this case, if not for maybe one of several other cases that, you know, may turn the tide and develop information on leading to a conviction.
There are other ways for police to find what they need in this muddy water. Get rid of it altogether.
And our next step would be obviously to dredge the pond and drain it and search it from that step, and that's certainly something we're looking into.
Now, the other problems officers have had is when they're in that water, there is so much garbage down there and they're using their hands to search around. They may feel something, pick something up, but it could be a Coke can, a bottle, a piece of a car, a bicycle. That's why really they're saying if they don't find anything with this latest dive, the next step might be to dredge it, something they have done before. We're live in Hartford. I'm Jamie Murrell, News 8.